Evangelist Made, information for transformation.
Ephesians chapter 6. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 12. Ephesians 6, 12. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against rulers of the darkness of this world, and against spiritual wickedness in high places. There is a fight going on. Whether you are aware or not does not matter. Whether you agree or you don't agree does not matter. You are in the fight anyway. Ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, when you begin to read your Bible, very soon you come across one name called Hagar. She's from Egypt. You come across another name called Keturah. She's also a black woman, a wife of Abraham. Then you come across Asenath, the wife of Joseph, a black woman. Then you come across Zipporah, the wife of Moses, a black woman. Then you come across a man called Jethro. Jethro was the father-in-law of Moses, and he taught Moses the ways of God. He was a black man. When you read on, you come across one name called Hobab, who used his knowledge to guide Israel through the wilderness. It was the eye of Israel in that difficult terrain called the wilderness. Then you must have read in your Bible about a woman called Rahab, who saved the spies. She was a black woman too. Then you come across a man called Ebedimelech. You find that in the book of Jeremiah. He was a black man. He was the one that rescued that prophet Jeremiah when he was thrown into the pit. And as you read on and read on and read on your Bible, you come across one man called Simeon of Cyrene. He was the one that was forced to carry the cross of Jesus when Jesus was going to die. He was a black man. And very soon as you read your Bible, you find the story of that Ethiopian eunuch that Philip ministered to. And he took the gospel to Ethiopia. The gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ got to Africa before it got to Europe. It hit this place first before it went to Europe. But the fire it was meant to catch did not catch. The gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, when it hit Nigeria, it went to Badagry. But the fire it was meant to catch there did not catch. The question is why? The names I've read that to you, they are names of black people in the Bible that God used to fulfill purposes. The gospel got to Africa before it got to Europe. And whenever God has a major step to take in the history of man, a black man will always come along. God has always used Africa to protect, to support, and provide for his move. Even when Jesus was born and Herod wanted to kill him, they had to take Jesus back to Africa in Egypt. So whenever the world was in a crisis, God has always made a black man to appear on the scene. But then if you're a good thinker, you will see that we got problems. The black man has problems. What exactly is wrong with the black man? Why did they tell funny jokes and funny stories about us? One white man was cracking a joke about Nigeria. He said in the beginning, God began to deposit minerals and natural resources in the world. And when God got to Nigeria, put oil, put tin, put coal, put all kinds of minerals here. And that other people now protested. I said, why are you putting so many things here? They said, God now said, wait until you see the kind of people I will put there. Why are they telling those kind of stories about us? Why are they saying that when God created human beings, Everybody had to wash in the swimming pool before they go out. And this large swimming pool, when God created the first set of people, they went to the swimming pool, they came out. Second group of people, they went to the swimming pool, they came out, and they were white men. But by the time the last person was supposed to go inside, the water was already dirty. So that person who went in last, his body now carried all the dirty things in the water, and it became black. Why did they make terrible statements about us? They say an average black man is stupid organization-wise. What's the reason for this domination of the black race when the Bible has a good destiny for them? How do we explain the misuse of the treasures God has deposited in Africa? What remove our brain that somebody will bring a piece of mirror, and because the chief can see himself in the mirror, he gave out 50 slaves to people. 50 people to exchange for a mirror just because the chief wants to see his face. Why did we go through this horrifying slave trade? And so if you find somebody in Lagos and you say, I'm from Taylor, I'm from Johnson, I'm from all those Oyibo names, they are names of slavery. Why is it so difficult to find a black nation that is doing very well? Why is there this demonic and diabolical attack from hell to stop the black man from fulfilling his mandate? Why should things like lack, poverty, inferiority, low class accommodation, insufficient education, why is it always been associated with black? What are the forces behind the black man's domination? Why is the black man so backward and we have become a group of consumers and we don't produce much? Why is it that even in nations where we are in majority, we fail? Why are we the richest continent and yet inhabited by the poorest people? The greatest minerals in the world is in Africa. Why is it that black nations constitute biggest borrower nations? Why do we always notice this big division between white-dominated and black-dominated nations? It is a lamentable tragedy that we have a black men killing themselves, and it becomes a case of black against black. Why is it that in the black country we have a black president feeding his people to lions to eat? Why is it that it's in Africa, somebody will capture an able-bodied man, and what you think you can do to punish him is to cut off his right hand? And when they catch the person, they'll ask you, do you want short sleeve or long sleeve? When you cut off the right hand of an able-bodied man, you have made him useless. Why is all this happening? Why is it that we're possessed by the spirit of the crab? You know the spirit of the crab? If you put plenty of crabs in a bucket, instead of the crabs, you allow each of them to come out one by one. When the first crab is trying to crawl out, the other crab pull him down. The spirit of the crab. Why is it that in African nations, we promote the inferior and demote the superior? Some time ago, I shared with you here, I schooled in a place called Akure. My first primary school was in Akure. There was a boy in that school. The day he was born, native doctors from 3 villages, they converged in the place he was born. And they prostrated for him. The mother said, Baba, stand up. We can't prostrate for a baby. No, they told the mother, no. This one is not a baby. This boy that has been born today, our oracle told us that he will bring glory to this area. He will be the best man here, and he will dominate in many areas of the world. Therefore, they gave him the name Irawo. Star. That was the name. Immediately, Irawo came into school. Every subject is 100%. Every subject. 100%. When Ira was in class, you know that somebody is in class. He was doing extremely well. Was my junior in school then, but he could answer questions from the senior classes. When primary 6 people get confused, they bring it to Ira in primary 4 to solve at the back of our school. There was a quick sand. This sand, when you get in, it's difficult. You can't come out. Muddy place. The school authority built a wall so that students don't go there at all. Only God knew what happened that day. How Irawa was able to climb the wall and went to the quicksand. Irawa sank. We could not even retrieve his corpse. Because if you go and try and retrieve his corpse, the person too will sink in the quicksand. And that was the end of that fellow whose life and staff was even made clear to satanic oracle. And he was even attending a Christian school. Some powers buried him. Can you raise up your right hand? And let your voice roar like thunder. Every power assigned to bury my son. Let your voice roar like thunder. Is that the loudest you can shout it here today? Death! In the name of Jesus. There is somebody who needs to shout this prayer loud and clear. Continue. This is not a time to come and negotiate here. There must be no negotiation. One more. With anger boiling in your spirit. Sir, arrows of witchcraft fired into my destiny. Because once your destiny is being shut down, that's it. Once the eagle of your destiny comes down, that's it. Can I hear somebody shouting that loud and clear? Backfire! In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. A louder amen. Have your seat for a few minutes more. I've told you what we're here to do today. Why is it that the black nation is a breadwinner's cemetery? It is that breadwinner that they want to kill. It's part of their African trouble and black trouble. Why is it that it's amongst blacks you find the youngest widow's factory? Kill their husbands off just like that. Why is it that in the black nation a lot of firstborns are used as torchlights for the others? So plenty firstborns are useless. But those coming behind them will be doing well. I pray that if you are a firstborn here today and your birthright has been stolen, repossess it now. Repossess it. In the name of Jesus. Why is it that it's in the black nation you have the greatest promoters of polygamy? Why is it that the evil we do to ourselves is greater than the evil that anybody does to us? Why is it that somebody in somebody's family will gather at a coven to destroy the person who is helping them? All because of envious witchcraft. I'm praying for somebody here that that because of envy, they are attacking you. Their arrows against you shall backfire now. Let your amen roar like thunder. Let your amen roar like thunder. In the name of Jesus. Why is it that it's in the black land? Quite plenty of wasted destinies. Wasted destiny. Why is it? And it's among the blacks. You have this trademark of sit tight and confused leadership. They don't want to leave the place. Why? They're confused. Why is it that is among the blacks you find plenty of senseless civil and tribal wars? Recently, we moved the mountain of fire and miracles mercy to a place called Rwanda. When I listened to what went on there, and the way people were wasted like paper, it was very sad. We had to quickly move in there. Plenty of blood now on the ground. Plenty of crying blood. Anywhere where there is shedding of blood is always so difficult. Why is it that in the black nation, you find the greatest volume of woman abuse? Many cases, the women are supposed to be seen and not heard. That's why somebody can order a woman who has just delivered a baby to be pounding yam for a relative who have come to greet her. An abuse of womanhood. That's why you find men who have their own, big men, sugar daddies, who have their own children studying abroad, who will go to the campus to gather campus, get the age of their daughters and be sleeping with them. It's in Africa. Why is it that in the black nation we have plenty of cemetery of good things? Cemetery of good things. In those days, when we started school, there are Christian schools, there are non-Christian schools. And if you want your children to have a Christian education, you send them to Christian schools. But now, plenty of confusion around. Even some of those schools, on Monday morning, they sing, "We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jehovah Almighty. Hoshem Baba, Baba Omashe." But by Friday, Allahu Akbar. So they come out confused. This is very sad. Cemetery of good things. Why is it that it's among the blacks you find the greatest non-reading culture? They don't want to read. That's why somebody said the best way to hide something from a black man is to put it in a book. That once you put it in a book, he won't read it. Why is it that we have so many greedy men and women? Let's face it, beloved, the black man is a very greedy man. They continually want more and more and more and more with little thoughts for others. Why is it that there are plenty of selfishness amongst us? I want a big house. I want a big car. And that is a sign that I have arrived. Unless you have arrived at nothing. Why is it that our place, the black nation, has the greatest number of satanic altars in all nations of the world? Why is it that if you buy things from our market, you don't pray on it, you may be in trouble? Why is it that it's in the black nation you have the greatest number of destructive, wicked witchcraft? Why is it that the poorest countries, mostly in Africa, they are the home of 1/5 of world's people, but they account for less of 2% of the global income? Why? What is the problem? There are 7 of them. The problems. 7 problems. The first problem is idolatry. Our forefathers did not serve God. They served the devil. And it's backfiring on us now. Secondly, sin and iniquity. What sin our fathers did, we're repeating it. 3, demon worship. Worship all kinds of terrible spirits that have not helped us at all. Some demon powers that the missionaries buried. Some people went and brought them up and began to worship them again. 4, sacrifices to dark powers. And when you stop the sacrifice, These dark powers will now begin to ask for their meat. Fifth, polygamy. That has destroyed so many rising stars. In an attempt for the polygamous women to defend their children, they kill off other children and they try and fortify their children with terrible powers. Six, that is responsible for what we are doing now. It's horrible spiritual ignorance. Ignorance. And then last but not the least, is the wicked witchcraft that has turned the black man upside down and has caused so many trouble. This God's judgment against witchcraft, straightforward. Thou shalt not suffer a witch to live. He didn't say, go and be killing human beings who are witches. No. What he's saying, that power should die. The power they are using to torment people. When that power is dead, there is nothing they can do to your life anymore. So the principle of Christians against witchcraft is very straightforward. You have to stop them before they stop you. If you don't stop them, they will stop you. It was at Old Yaba Road. An Igbo man rushed into the meeting and said, man of God, I need prayer. Between January and July, they've lost 13 people in their company. 13 people dead in one household in 6 months. And he told me that as he was talking to me, then there were only two of them left. Himself and his junior brother. And he brought the junior brother along. I said, okay. So now that you have entered into this list, you shall not die but live. He said, amen. So, but do you go to church? I said, I go to church. Which one? The Catholic. I said, well, that won't deliver you now. You need more serious prayers. So I now prayed for him. Gave him anointing. I said, there is a pidgin proverb. The king will say, mama, no go sleep. Himself, no go sleep. So henceforth, forget sleeping now. 12 midnight today, wake up. And begin to pray these prayers. Anoint yourself, begin to pray. And then, don't go anywhere now. Don't travel. Just pray the prayers. As I was talking, his junior brother there was making noise at me. I had to go and collect my luggage in the village. I have to go. And I said, don't you hear what the man of God is saying? I have to go. His brother went home. 12 midnight, he started prayers. He got to one point in the prayer program, which says, oh Lord, ordain terrifying noises against my enemies. He said, as he put his mouth on that prayer point, pandemonium broke out. That the kind of bullet, gunshots, artillery bombardment he was hearing, the last time he had that kind of bombardment was during Nigerian Civil War. And his head was shaking on the bed. He couldn't pray the prayers again. Then God opened his eyes. He saw the bullets and the guns and those things being thrown at him. But he said, below his bed, there was a tall man in white garment who was just doing everything like this. Doing everything like this. The bullets did not touch him. The noise was great and loud, but the angels was shaking them. He couldn't pray again. In fact, they had to admit him to the hospital. God delivered him. But his junior brother who traveled, he got to the village all right, gathered his things. On the way out of the village, his vehicle collided with a petrol tanker. His vehicle caught fire. He couldn't come out. By the time they found him, he was a mass of ash on his seat, and his luggage was a smaller ash of pack of ash. That was the end of that brother. Only this man remained alive. Do you think that the powers that killed 13 people in 6 months and then finished that boy because they didn't want the boy to come to Lagos and start any prayer? You think it's something you toy or play with? The powers that saw the star of Irawa and they sank him in school. You think that this is just play around with? By the time Jehu faced Jezebel, the witch, he looked up. I said, is that Jezebel? I said, yes. I said, those two people that are by our side. So now, carry her. Throw her down. They carried Jezebel up and threw her down. according to the, so that the prophecy of Elijah will come to pass. That where dogs licked the blood of Naboth, there they shall lick that of Jezebel. That's why I'm praying for somebody here. That any power that wants to drink your blood, they shall drink their own blood. In the name of Jesus. Rise up on your feet now. This is why we are here. And we're not here to play or to joke. Many of us will have been in better places, more properly positioned, if not for these powers that have caused trouble for us. I see plenty of deliverance taking place here this morning. I see plenty of destinies being restored. All eyes closed. Seven people are here. You have been complaining that I have never received any solid miracle. This morning is your morning. That sister over there, they laid a witchcraft hand upon your breast and upon your womb. Immediately we start now. There will be volcanic eruption in that womb. And shall be instantly delivered. Don't say, I don't think these prayers concern me. Pray them the way you've never prayed before. Can I hear the sister saying this after me? Anything planted in my life by witchcraft powers. Can I hear the sisters? Sisters, is that the way you want to pray here this morning? There is still a sister who needs to shout this loud and clear. Brother, roll a thunder! Everybody together now! Yeah! In the name of Jesus. The power of God. In the name of Jesus. Yes. From the top of the head to the sole of the feet. Be released. Aha! I told you! Masikatandaya boshente rabokoraba. Center. In Jesus' name we pray. You see what I told you? So what is happening now? The Bible's pronouncement is kill them. Didn't say play with them or pacify them. Before you pray this next prayer, I want you to sing this song to send fear into the camp of the Kobuns. Let your voices be loud and clear.
Unshakable must be shaken. All the way to keep on moving. I'm serving a God of fire. Unshakable must be.
Hallelujah.
Unshakable
must be
shaken.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
God of Elijah, send on fire. 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 Hallelujah. Holy Ghost arise in your power. Holy Ghost arise in your power. Ready to deliver, ready to save. Ready to deliver, ready to set me free.
Holy Ghost arise in your power.
Holy Ghost arise in your power. Holy Ghost arise, oh!
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 Holy Ghost
arise, oh!
Holy Ghost arise, oh!
Holy Ghost arise,
oh!
Holy Ghost arise, oh!
Holy Ghost arise, oh! Say, witchcraft power! Assigned against my life! Carry your load! In the name of Jesus! Open your mouth and begin to ask them to carry their load! Today is today. Aha, aha. Continue. Thou power of God, in the name of Jesus. Aha. In Jesus' name we pray. If you are afraid, don't pray this third prayer. Because anything can happen. Every evil bird flying against my destiny, I shoot you down. Can I hear the sister shouting this? Is that the loudest sisters can call this prayer? Yes. Brothers, let your voice roar like fire. Everybody together now. In the name of Jesus. That's right. Don't negotiate. Today is not a day to negotiate. In Jesus' name we pray. This next prayer, the Lord said, pray three times. Put whatever you want inside your own. If you like, say my finances. If you like, say my marriage. If you like, say my career. Put whatever you like inside. But these three times, pray with merciless violence. Witchcraft embargo on my career. You can put whatever you want inside your own.
Can I hear you shouting loud and clear? Death! In the name of Jesus, kill the embargo. Makato sente la kayabo shente raba. Ribostoponde kayabo shente raba. Something is happening here this morning. Yes, 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 yes. We are here for serious business. Pray. Open your mouth and pray the second time. Yes. Thank you, Jesus. 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 In Jesus' name we pray. Number three, open your mouth and pray. Aha, 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 aha. Name we pray. Silence now, beloved. Silence. If that's your egg gear is disturbing you, put it down. Put it down. We're not here to play. We're here to fight. Many have suffered for too long. Why is somebody that the Lord ordained to be a landlord, if it's a permanent tenant, he needs to fight? When somebody the Lord ordained to be an employer of labor is now looking for a job to even do, then there is a problem. There is a problem somewhere. A major part of this problem is due to powers and activities of witchcraft. I want to pray for three people before we go on. The first person, the truth is that the real you is not there again. They have withdrawn the real you. That's why you cannot get anything to work. Father, I pray for this person. That right there where the person is, your power will fall upon the person. And the yoke of this fake life, break now in the name of Jesus. That's right. Now I pray for this second person too. That witchcraft sponsored infirmity in your body that is confusing the doctors. Immediately I say in the name of Jesus now, that yoke shall break and the infirmity shall go back to the center. You the witchcraft infirmity, hear the word of the Lord. That place is not your place. It is the tabernacle of the Most High God. So you've made a mistake by going into this life. Right there where you are. Get out in the name of Jesus. Aha. Something is happening over there. Yes. The theater of the Almighty has started surgery. Surgery on somebody over there. I'm praying for this person over there too. Parental witchcraft has seen to it that you do not rise. Right there where you are. Receive your deliverance in the name of Jesus.
receive it, 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 receive it.
Thou power of God, in the name of Jesus, move. Masikaya boshente rabakante. Amen. Aha. Aha. Yes. That person over there, today is actually your first day here. But thank God you came. Because you've been completely swallowed by these witchcraft powers. Right there where you are, they are vomiting you. That's right. This is your first day. They are vomiting you. They swallowed you already. But they are vomiting you now. The arrow fired into that right leg. The one fired into the right breast. Look at what is happening now. The arrows are going back to the senders. Now, the next three prayers. Pray mercilessly and violently. Carbon agenda. For my progress. I have some people here who will need to move forward by fire. Can I hear your voice roaring like thunder? Is that the loudest you can say it? Is that still the loudest you can say it? I still want your voice loud and clear. In the name of Jesus, destroy the common agenda. Louder, 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 louder. Aha, aha, aha. Jesus' name we pray. That's right. That is right, sister. Continue that. Don't relax. That sister, don't relax. Continue. Just a little bit more. A little bit more. Just a little bit more. And you push yourself into breakthrough. Where is the Lord God of Elijah? Can you shout that loud and clear? Let my story change in the name of Jesus. Jesus' name we pray. You will sing this song before you now go into this third one. Yes. Sing it before you now go into this next one. Lifted, I am lifted, I am lifted by the Lord. Out of sin and sorrow, into the presence of the Lord. Are you lifted, Lord?
I am lifted, yes, sir. I am lifted by the Lord. Out of sin and sorrow, into the presence of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yes. I am lifted by the Lord. Out of
sin and sorrow,
into the presence of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I am lifted by the Lord. Out of sin and sorrow, into the presence of the Lord.
To lift my head. Is that the loudest you can say it? I bury you now in the name of Jesus. Name we pray. Now, right there where you are, this is the end of our first session of prayers. This first session, if you believe that the Lord has answered your prayers, take any song of praises and sing it loud and clear to the King of Kings and to the Lord of Lords. Great is His name. However they say, we go back the world because of the mighty Red Sea. I see the never leave. Jesus' name. Amen. Now we grow into our closing prayers. Mommy Johnson was a woman who stayed for many years in England. She joined an Orthodox church. And because she was the only one who used to bring British hats to church on Sunday, they made her the chairlady of Ladies Guild Society. The only qualification of Mommy Johnson for that post was because of her British hat and because she speaks British English. What Mommy Johnson did not know that every lady in that society was a witch. She was the only one who was not. Then the harvest came. In the harvest, she was supposed to carry a Pyrex plate with money and dance to the front on behalf of the society. So Mommy Johnson was given a Pyrex plate with money of the society inside to take to the altar. And all those people, all the ladies began to sing, Mommy Johnson, it is your time to fly. It is your time. It is your time. It is your time to fly. She sang. Didn't understand what the flying was all about. Then she got home at night. And one of the ladies entered into her room through the wall, not the door. Said, Mommy, let's go. Said, to where? Our meeting. Say, which meeting? Say, which is now? Say, me. I'm not part of you. I said, but you said it was your turn to fly. They took her along. This was how the problem of Mrs. Johnson started. And it spread over to everything she was doing. There is some bondage called unconscious bondage. There is a bondage called forced bondage. Mommy Johnson was initiated without her knowledge. So she became a blind witch. This is the area we want to go to now. What may be affecting you that you are completely unconscious of? You don't know. Whether you know or you don't know, that's what we want to deal with now. Everybody on your feet and let your fire prayer roar like thunder. Every negative dedication of my life, I cancel you now. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and declare it. That's right. In Jesus' name we pray. Now like fire, like thunder, say, unconscious bondage tormenting my star. Death! In the name of Jesus. That's right. That's right. In Jesus' name we pray. Say, environmental witchcraft. A sign against my staff of bread. Can you say that loud and clear? Scatter in the name of Jesus. Jesus' name we pray. The last prayer, but I want you to pray before you go. But before we pray that one, let me congratulate all of you who came for this service. Glory be to the name of Jesus. Say this as a command, as a proclamation, and as an order. Whenever witches appear before me, they must be disgraced. That's right. Can you shout out loud and clear? In the name of Jesus, they must be disgraced. In Jesus' name we pray. As you go into this week, I bless you in the name of Jesus. Your going and your coming out shall be blessings. I cover you and your family with the blood of Jesus. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. The Lord will bless you from Zion and make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. You will go from strength to strength. And you go from glory to glory. You shall be a victor. And not a victim. You shall love your enemies to scorn. You shall receive unusual, uncommon laughter. Your story shall change. The Lord will raise a voice for you. Everywhere you go. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Lord, all the prayer requests, answer them by fire. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Thanks for watching. Remember to click the subscribe button and the notification bell beside it to be updated with Ebenezer Meek channel's video whenever available. Don't forget to comment, like, and share the video with your friends and family. Bye.